time of year again, edible book contest, festival, really. Celebration of the book and of food, all to benefit Forbes Library. It's a sunny day here in Florence after 2 days of snow. We're all amazed by our good fortune with this beautiful sunny day. And today is the day for the edible book contest or festival. It's not really a contest. Some examples of years gone by. Let's go see what's going on this year. Benefit for Forbes Library. Here we are, the preparations are going smoothly. Judges are making their final rounds.
Well, my name is Dee Michelle. I'm pretty much the organizer this year of the Edible Book Festival, which is a benefit for the Friends of Forbes Library. And there's information at the table as you checked in about Friends of Forbes if you're interested. And there are a couple of members of the board of the Friends. If you could raise your hands. Friends, people, if you can see if you have any questions about them. You can talk to Mary or Martha. Basically what the Friends does is raise money to help with the collection services of Forbes Library. And this is done every year. The Friends has other benefits. They also put on the garden tour, which many of you may be familiar with. And I want to thank the Florence Civic Association for letting us use this space. And also Bonnie Burnham, who was the organizer in the past since 2007 when this started at Forbes. And actually before that, there were 1 or 2 years where the Edible Book began at ZMA's printmaking studio, and Liz Chalfin organized that. So let me introduce our celebrity judges this year. What we tried to do is get representatives of different relevant fields of endeavor. So you try to have a librarian or a book person or a writer or a literary eminence, and our literary eminence this year is Leslie Newman. One of her books is actually featured in the Edible Book this year. And then in terms of the food half, we try to get somebody from a restaurant or a baking or a cooking expert. And we have a representative of a kitchen supply place, the Baker's Pin, Dennis Kleppel here. And then it's also great if we can actually tap the government public interest. And so we try to get representatives or public figures, I guess. So our public figure this year, we're really honored to have Jody Casper, who's the chief of police in Northampton. So what we'll do now is have, we'll start the beginning of the alphabet with Alice's Adventures in Wonderland. And if each person who created or people who created the entry, if they want to, you don't have to. If you want to talk a little bit about your inspiration, what prompted you to use this particular book or this particular title, and also if you came up with any engineering challenges or things that were easy or hard to do, different. Sometimes people have one idea in mind and then it comes out really different. So any, as little or as much you want to talk about your creation, it would be great. And then the judges will explain the reasoning behind and give the award and the reasoning behind it.
And we have 3 different things here. We have the rabbit hole right here. We have like the chessboard right here, which I think is really cool. And then we have the grass where there's a little flamingo where the Queen of Hearts is playing croquet. And it says I'm late and we're all mad here. And it was, the difficult part was getting Alice, because she's very, very heavy, to stay on this part of the cake without tipping it this way. So that was a bit of a challenge, but I figured out a way to keep it. So.
No judging the judges. We did our very best. For this award, we really loved all the characters that you had on it, and certainly we made note of the whole. So your award is the Hole, H-O-L-E, the Hole Cast of Characters Award.
This is Jim Figgy, and he made Calvin and Hobbes out of fruit. We had a hard time because we have many, many Calvin and Hobbes books. But he ultimately decided on page 101 in there, there's actually a picture of the Calvin and Hobbes that we recreated in fruit. The big challenges were making Hobbes' hands, so watch out if you eat these later. The marshmallows do have toothpicks in them. Those are a choking hazard, and those are not edible.
So we really loved how we immediately recognized Calvin and Hobbes. We knew who they were, and so we gave you the very, very fierce Tiger, Tiger, Burning Bright Award. And Tiger, Tiger, Burning Bright is a very famous poem because we thought it was a very poetic rendition of the characters.
My mother wrote kids' books. Her name was Eve Marion for most of the things she published. But very early in her career, she did a book called Cat in the Box under the name of Dana Michelle. And I thought it'd be fun to make a cat in the box. And so I made a cat out of halva. And the first attempt, I tried to have it standing up like this one, and it just started to snag. And then I also used marzipan, and it sagged even more. I tried to prop it up with pretzel sticks. So then I thought I would just go with a flatter cat. I have a cat that often curls up in that ball like position. And then I made the box out of crackers. And the fondant was the blanket. And this, since I had the marzipan to make the cat, I thought, well, maybe I'll make another cat. So I thought of the Cat in the Hat. And rather than just doing a regular kind of hat like that, I made a pussy hat that was used in the marches after our president was inaugurated. So this is sort of a nod to the politics of the moment. So this is the Cat in the Hat. It doesn't look like that hat. So the whole thing is called Cats and Things.
Okay, so one of the things that I liked is the way you're catching the cats and what cats do most. So we gave this the Perfect Pussycat Hatbox Award.
Hi, I'm Stacia, and this is my team. This is Reese, he is in third grade, and this is Darren, and she goes to Cloverdale right down the street, and she's going to hide. So you might be wondering why we have nose flowers, and you may not know about this book, but it's called Dangerously Ever After. It's the story of a princess who only likes dangerous things. And she's a gardener, so everything in her garden is dangerous. She has swinging mace vines and heckleberries that throw insults at you when you walk by, and stinging nettles. So somebody brings her some roses, because they know she's a gardener. And at first she's like, I don't want these. These are not dangerous. Until she pricks her finger, and they have thorns on them. She's like, oh, these are great. I want these for my garden. So she sends a note. And it says, please send Princess Emerita some rose seeds. But she has terrible handwriting, and what she gets are nose seeds. So then when they bloom, they are stems full of noses, and they cause such a problem. They are allergic to everything. They sneeze and they sniffle all night long and keep the whole kingdom awake. So anyway, she eventually brings them back to where they came from, and she gets the rose seeds, and she's very happy, and the noses are happy to be back in the kingdom they're not allergic to. So this was our inspiration. We love this book so much, and this is the picture that inspired our creation. It was definitely some engineering challenges, but mostly they are Rice Krispie treats dipped, and then once we formed them, we dipped them in candy melts to give them a hard coating. And then the base is also chocolate Rice Krispie treats for the dirt.
So we loved how realistic these were compared to the book. We certainly went, wow, look at that, that's fantastic. What a great rendition of the book. And of course, we instantly took time to smell the roses.
And then
names the award the Noses Never Smelled So Sweet Award.
The creation of Oliver Yao. And he chose Don't Let the Pigeon Drive the Bus, one of our favorite books. But we decided that this picture was going to be the inspiration, where the pigeon actually does get to drive the bus. If you've read the book, you know the pigeon gets very, very frustrated that he's not allowed to drive the bus. So we thought we'd give him the opportunity. And did you want me to talk about what it's made of? Okay, so it's not a cake, it's a giant brownie. And we use graham crackers and cookies and fruit leathers for all the different pieces.
Well, this cake is so realistic looking. It looks exactly like the picture in the book. So we gave it the PVPA instead of PVTA, the Pioneer Valley Pigeon Award.
Hi, I'm John Riley, and I'm working with my wife, Patty, again this year. I think this is about our 10th time doing this. We own Gabriel Books downtown, and two things we like are food and books, so this is a natural for us. This year we did an edible rainbow garden. All the healthiest foods you can eat have colors, they have all the vitamins. We have a chart here. Red is good for your heart. Oh, you're going to get a chart spanking when I'm done here. Orange is good for healthy eyes. And so take a look at this chart and you'll be able to figure this all out. And we also have some edible flowers. So that's our entry this year. The letters came from a box of cookies we got at the dollar store about 6 months ago, and we knew we were going to be able to use these. So we hang on and send the painting for 6 months, waiting for this moment.
I'm actually impressed that it was only one box of cookies, because I was thinking you'd have to eat through like four boxes of cookies.
It was amazing.
So the thing that we were most impressed by was all the colors. So we went with the color theme of the Roybib.
Roy G. Bibb.
To the letter award.
Thank you.
This time I'm representing Alex Stakey, and he opted to make a tribute to the Flying Beaver Brothers, which is a series of great comic books for kids this age about two brothers who are beavers who are named
Ace and Bub.
And Ace and Bub have a bunch of adventures. In this particular iteration, we couldn't make them fly, so they're frying Beaver Brothers. This one's Ace, that one's Bub. They have marshmallow teeth, and they're made of pancakes and waffles for the tails, and their pants are made of fruit leather. And they have two friends who are named Bob and Bob, who are both penguins. This one's Bob, no, that one's Bob, and that one's Bob. And one of them has a spatula named Cynthia. And Bob and Bob once made them a house out of a variety of poor building choices, which turned into a not very habitable residence. So Alex carefully made that out of marshmallows and toothpicks. Again, special note, toothpicks are not edible.
So for this award, one thing that certainly stood out was the beaver tails. We really liked the detail on the waffles and how much they look like beaver tails. We named this the Pass the Maple Syrup Award.
Hello, thank you so much. I'm Lisa Downing, I'm the director of Forbes Library, so I have the privilege of being an edible book creator with my daughter here, Shaylee, and also being the beneficiary for our community for all the great work that the Friends do, and this fundraiser is so much fun. Thank you all for coming out today. So we, after I saw the one next door, feeling quite inadequate, but that's okay. We took a much different approach. We sort of focused on the end of the book.
Mommy, you let it snow!
The kids picked the book. I did the cutting, and we're talking about the end of the book, where the tree is no longer serving its purpose as a tree, but it's serving its purpose as a stool and a place for the old man to sit. And it's a book that's fantastic, and I encourage everyone to read it often.
And
and we gave this the Everything I Have Is Yours Award.
And
the
theme
of it.
When I asked Leslie to be one of the judges, I thought it would be fun to do a book of hers. And I was playing around with the title, Heather Has Two Mommies, and eventually I came up with Keith Barr Has Two Guns. So I created a genealogy tree with Keith Barr at the bottom, and Keith Barr has got two cookies as the parents, and then grandparents or other kinds of candy. The structure of the genealogy tree is all from Bill and Ted's or Ben and Ted's, whatever the name, BenandBill.com, the chocolate place.
Well, we just have to give this two awards, because my special award for this is the Leslie Newman Ego Stroking Award. But then we also came up with the Setting the Candy Bar High Equality Award.
Hi, I'm Martha McCormick. I'm the president of the Friends of Forbes Library. And this is the first year that I've actually entered into this event. And I made The House of Sand and Fog, which is a favorite book of mine, and I always had an inspiration to do this, but I finally got around to doing it. A House with Sand and Fog. And I made it out of just a yellow cake mix. It's three layers of cake and then graham crackers to give the shape of the roof, and that's about it. The fog is made out of cotton candy, which I had a different vision of what cotton candy was going to look like on here. But, you know, you get the idea. So.
So when this started, there may or may not have been more fog.
Yeah.
Things happen with maple cotton candy. We looked at it. Great. We loved it. We wanted to move into it. We named it the Sweet Treat Retreat Award. Oh. See, these are not easy.
Hi, I'm Erin Kenny, and I worked on this with my friends Jessica and Lisa. It has always been my favorite book since I read it in seventh grade, and it scared me so much I couldn't sleep in the same room with a book. So I wanted to do a tribute to Pennywise, so we called ours Pennywise the Dancing Cake instead of Pennywise the Dancing Clown. And we used, it's all vegan, we used a rainbow vanilla cake and butter or cream cheese frosting, cotton candy for the hair, some fondant, and then this like edible paper. So that's that.
All right, so we were particularly impressed by the hair. And there was a lot of different directions to go with this, and I think we just combined them all into the hairy, scary, no clowning around, Pennywise Pound Foolish.
Hi, I'm Stephen Preer. These are my daughters, Nora and Audrey, and my wife, Reese. This is a team effort. We're big fans of Roald Dahl, so we chose James and the Giant Peach. We're trying to think of something that was kind of a book with food as a central idea. So this is, it's a yellow cake. There's a layer of peach mousse in the middle, and also the peach itself is filled with that. The frosting is done with a buttercream transfer, a frozen buttercream transfer, where you pipe the buttercream onto a sheet of wax paper, and then you put it in the freezer. And then you can transfer it, and then all the little insect companions for James are made out of chocolate. That's it.
So we loved the bugs, and also how it really looks like a book, especially the side where you can see the pages. So we gave it the Peachy Keen Extra Protein Award.
One too was a team effort. I'm Marilyn Greco, Mary Nesick, my partner, and my daughter, Pasqualina Azzarello. And Mary and I are in a book club, and they were reading The Language of Flowers this month, but I love the book. And the same day I went to get the book from the library, I found out about the edible books event. And so we just moved here. I'd never heard about anything like this, but I thought it was a great idea. I wanted to support it.
And the book is about a young girl, well, she's growing up and she's in foster care, and she finds her way through life with flowers. And she, every flower has a symbol. The tulips are a symbol of imagination, and the lupins are a symbol of the devotion of love. And so this was a task of imagination and devotion of love for the three of us to symbolize or represent the language of flowers.
What we noticed most about this was the impressive scratching that you did, or carving, or whatever you want to call that. We were so impressed with your ability to do that. We've never seen it done. Great job. And it was. And we also just enjoyed looking at it. It looked like a very friendly person. We named it the Most Beautiful Eyes and Smile Award.
Okay, so this team, Phil, Maya, and their mom, I'm Andrea, and Phil and Maya. Phyllis and Maya's favorite book is one of their favorite books is Squish. It's a graphic novel series for young readers. They are 7 and 9, and we created the main characters, who are Squish, Pot, and Peggy, 3 amoebas, and we created them with.
What's this cool stuff that gets soggy?
Not very soggy, our yellow, and I try to implement some nature study as well, and that messed it totally up. So we use some candy for like the real parts of the amoeba, and we also use some marzipan and spaghetti for some details.
Okay, so this was great too, and obviously the jello and the squiggliness is what we were steering towards. We were a little bit wondering what was all inside of the jello there. Yeah. But we gave this the Wiggly Swiggly Jiggly Award.
Yellow cake with vanilla frosting with gel food coloring, and made like a little path in the middle. And he's just an Easter chocolate bunny with his little jacket's made of arrowheads, and then he got the apple ring candy for the little lettuce and the red Tic Tacs for the radishes and just the fences and the little pasta. And here he is just, you know, he squeezed into the garden, and he's eating here right before he's going to get caught in the storm garden.
So we all know that Peter Rabbit got in a little trouble, so we named this the I Should Have Listened to Flopsy, Mopsy, and Cottontail Award. And also, it was pointed out to me the beautiful book that goes into great, great detail about all the ingredients. So we gave it also the Most Thorough Explanation of Ingredients Award.
The tree, we had a lot of issues as far as that went, trying to sculpt it, because it's actually just all Rice Krispie treat, the trunk of it, and then it's coated with chocolate for sturdiness so it would stand up and not fall all over the place when we put all of the weight from all the popcorn on top of it.
It's so heavy.
Yeah, it is pretty heavy, actually, and it's very sturdy as well.
It's a whole box of cereal.
That it is. But, yeah.
Oh, here, I'll jump in. So yeah,
the bottom, oh wow, it's loud. So the bottom of it is all confetti cake, and then we did frosting on it, and she did this really awesome piping job with all of the grass to make it look real like that. And then we did, I think it's cherry candies to make them look like apples and make them small enough. And then this little guy over here was a challenge to make. He's all fondant, and we dyed all of it and then rolled it all together and made the little guy and stuck him all together with water and whatnot. And yeah, it was fun.
A guy from the CC here for a green. That was
So having given my children a hand with their creations, I wanted to do, with children's books, I wanted to do a grown-up book for mine. And so I picked the book Tipping the Velvet, which is a fabulous read, highly recommended. And to demonstrate that, I made a red velvet cake and figured out a way to get it to tip. My initial thought was to tip it at a higher angle, but my wife pointed out it was going to be a huge mess. So there it is, tipping at a slight angle. The book is about a woman who starts life as an oyster seller, and the first line in the book is, "Have you ever tasted a Winstable oyster?" And I thought it would be a fun challenge to try to make oysters. So these are chocolate oysters on a bed of rock candy. And if they look gross, it's because when you look up pictures of oysters online, they are kind of gross. So.
Luckily, we have one of the judges who knows Emily Dickinson quotes.
So this got the Emily Dickinson Tell the Truth But Tell It Slant Award.
Hello, I'm Justine Jasper, and this is my husband Nate, who's been doing the slideshow, and this is our creation, 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea, with banana squid, papaya submarine, and chocolate sailors, and some blueberries underneath for the ocean. Some people have been asking how we got the suction cups on the tentacles, and that was with the cap of a marker that we just pressed in, and it bruised the banana and made the shape. So, Nate?
We learned a lot about how to work with chocolate and how not to work with it. You might notice that this guy's spear is a little curved. It's supposed to be straight. And also the axe isn't really quite an axe, more of like a blob. But anyway, given more time, we might have had a little more sharp details, but it's really fun, great event, and so fun to make. Can't wait to eat all this stuff. Thanks everybody for coming.
Okay, so we were particularly impressed by the squid and the little suction cups on the squid. Really well done. And I also like how the suspense of the scene is really there with the guy pulled in. So we gave this the Out of Their League Banana Split Squid Award.
I'm a librarian, and it was very hard for me to choose a book. So I chose to do the passport for everyone to have access to all the books. I did a library card. It's a lemon cake with lemon frosting and black icing. All nice. Edible.
Glenny just used the word access because we gave you the Sweet Access Award.
My name is Michael, and I think we should eat, so I'm going to be very brief and tell you that we did a key lime pie for a wrinkle in time, and we put sprinkles on top of it, so it is a sprinkle in lime.
All right, and the last award, this was a challenge, and I'm going to slowly say it. We gave you the Time Line Lime Rhyme Award.
Oh dear. Oh. Oh.